Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, welcome back to yet another video from BioBuddy. And in this video, we will be moving forward with the next organelle, that is our mitochondria and our plastids. Right, very very simple, very very easy. So we have given names to the specific organelles till now. We have been given them, right? What was the first name? Endoplasmic reticulum. What was it? Manufacturer. Right, then comes to Golgi body, transporter and packer. Packer and transporter. Then what was the last one? Before this one, we had studied what? We had studied endoplasmic reticulum, we had studied Golgi body. Then after that, we had studied about the lysosomes. Lysosomes are what, beta? Suicidal glands. Now we are moving on to mitochondria. Okay, so mitochondria, the name given to the mitochondria is very nice. What is it? It is known as the powerhouse of the cell. What is it? The powerhouse of the cell. That means inside the cell, with all the functions which are being performed, they also require energy, right? And who is providing them the energy? Mitochondria is providing them the energy, right? So mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of the cell. Okay, it performs, the cell performs, cell has to perform a lot of chemical reactions. Cell performs chemical reactions for which energy is required. So who gives the energy, beta? Energy is being given by mitochondria in the form of ATP. What is ATP, beta? Adenosine triphosphate. Okay, so ATP is being generated inside the mitochondria, beta, which is helping them in providing energy. This is the function, that this is the powerhouse of the cell. It is performing the chemical reactions for which the energy is required. Who is giving that energy? The mitochondria is giving that energy in the form of ATP. Now let's come to the structure, beta. You can see this is also a double membrane bound structure. Outer membrane is porous in nature, it has small pores. Inner membrane is deeply folded. And outer membrane has, beta, tiny tiny pores. Right? So it is porous in nature. Fine? So it is a double layered structure. Fine? Now, beta, energy currency of the cell, aisa question aa sakta hai. Important. What is the energy currency of the cell? Energy currency of the cell. What will you say? It is ATP. ATP is the energy currency of the cell. Fine. Now, very important question again, beta. Or you can say, I am telling you a point, but this can also be coming as a question in your exam. That mitochondria has its own DNA and ribosome. Okay. So, DNA and ribosome are present in what? Mitochondria. They have their own DNA and ribosome. DNA and ribosome वैसे तो cell में होते ही हैं, beta. But there are some specific cell organelles also which they have their own DNA and their own ribosomes. So that is why they have the ability to form their own proteins. They have the ability to form their own proteins. Simple? Okay? Ab sabke paas to nahi hota. Only mitochondria and one other organelle is there which I'll be telling you. Okay? But mitochondria has its own DNA and ribosome which is leading to the formation of their own protein. Fine. So this is all about mitochondria, and this is the diagram of the mitochondria, beta. You can see these structures which are highly folded. These are inner membrane, right? And these are known as cristae, and this outer membrane is porous in nature. Fine. Now I'm erasing this space and let's move to the plastids. So beta, plastids are very very simple structures. You can see here, this is a plastid. Now, plastids ke baare mein, I have told you, beta, that plastids are present in which cells and absent in which cells, beta? Plastids are present in, beta, plant cell. They are present in plant cell, but they are absent in animal cell. Okay, they are present in plant cells, but they are absent in animal cell. And plastids beta lead to the formation of food in plants. Food in plants. Got it? So beta, plastids ka function kya hota hai? It is helping in the formation of food in the plants. Now, what are these plastids beta? Plastids are beta this. This is a structure of plastid. Okay, this is again a double membrane bound organelle and it has stacks arranged parallelly each other. Okay, each single coin beta here is known as a thylakoid, and a group of coins, these are coins, seem to be like coins. So single coin is known as a thylakoid and the stack entire is known as grana. And there are empty spaces which are known as stroma. Okay, so this is the structure of plastids beta and it is absent in case of animal cells but present in case of plant cell. Now, these plastids are also two types beta. Chromoplast. These are the colored plastids. Colored ones and leucoplast. Leucoplast, they are the colorless plastids. They are the colorless plastids. Okay, so chromoplasts have a special feature. What? They have a special pigment causing chloroplast. They have chloroplast. They have chloroplast. Chloroplast is sabko pata hai. You have studied chloroplast now. Okay, so chloroplast is a special plastid which has a green colored pigment called as beta chlorophyll. They have a green colored pigment called as chlorophyll that helps in the process of formation of food in green plants in the presence of sunlight, water and CO2. Fine. Now, beta, next is that these leucoplasts, ma'am, you have just said that these leucoplasts, they are colorless plastids. So, beta, these leucoplasts, they help in storing of fats, lipids, oils, starch, etc. Okay, these also help in storing these fats, oil, lipids, and plastids have their own again DNA and ribosomes. Plastic ke paas bhi apna kya hota hai beta? DNA and ribosomes. So they can also synthesize their own proteins. Question can come in the exam that name two organelles which have their own DNA and ribosome. What will you say? It is mitochondria and plastid. Or you can say name the plastids and mitochondria. They have dash and dash. They have their own dash and dash. What will you say? You will say that they have their own what? DNA and ribosome. Okay, which is leading to the formation of beta what? Their own proteins. Fine. Now let me erase this and let us move to the next organelle, that is beta vacuole. Okay, so I have told you vacuoles many times when you were studying the plant in the animal cell also beta. The next organelle is vacuole. So beta, vacuole are basically the storing sac. It is the storing sac, or they are used for storage purpose. In plant cell beta, there is a single large vacuole, you can see single central vacuole, right, which is occupying basically 50 to 70% of their space. Single vacuole in plant cell. Whereas if I talk about animal cell beta, there are many small vacuoles in animal cell. Many small vacuoles in animal cell. Okay? Animal cells mein kya hota hai beta? The vacuoles are very, very small. Now, vacuoles, what are they doing beta? They are storing cell sap and they provide turgidity and rigidity. This is the structure of vacuole. Simple. Okay? They provide turgidity and beta rigidity They provide turgidity and rigidity to the cell and also stores cell sap. Cell sap. Okay, it is also leading to the storage of cell sap. And it also stores bitter substances like, you can say, amino acids, sugars, starch, etc. ठीक है, ये सब भी ये स्टोर कर सकता है वैक्यूम. ओके, एनिमल सेल्स में कैसा होता है बेटा? एनिमल सेल्स में इट इज अ स्मॉल, मेनी मेनी वैक्यूल्स आर देयर. इन प्लांट सेल व्हाट इज हैपन, सिंगल सेंट्रल वैक्यूल इज प्रेजेंट विच इज लार्ज इन साइज. ओके, नाउ बेटा सम यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स बेटा दे हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स, दे हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ वैक्यूल्स. फर्स्ट इज द फूड वैक्यूल एंड अदर वन इज द स्पेशलाइज्ड वैक्यूल. Specialized vacuole. Okay, so this food vacuole is basically helping in what beta? It is helping in the storage of the food, right? And some of the specialized vacuole, they help in the elimination of what beta, or the expulsion of water, and also helps in osmoregulation. Okay, so this is all about our vacuole. Food vacuole stores the food. Specialized vacuoles helps in the expelling of water and our waste products. Okay, food vacuole में क्या होता है बेटा? Food vacuole में अंदर जाके the food is basically being stored in the form of amino acids, sugar, starch, and cell sap, and it is providing rigidity and turgidity to the cell. Right? Very simple. So we had covered all the things in this beta. Vacuole is covered. Now the next video will be about your cell, how it is dividing, right? Meiosis, mitosis, what is haploid, what is diploid. Okay? So stay tuned for the next video. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel, beta. Right? I'll see you guys in the next video.